Hi, welcome to another episode of the On.NET Show. Today we're going to be talking to Avi Avni, who's a .NET community developer. We're going to be talking about what it's like to work with the .NET team on GitHub. Okay, welcome Avi. How about you, quickly tell us a little bit about yourself, and then we'll kind of dig into the topic.
Okay, thanks, Richard. So my name is Avi Avni, and I am a consultant at a company called Sela for consulting for the .NET developers. And in my free time, I am contributing to open source projects. And it's really amazing to get the feedback from the community. And it's really exciting to do this contribution and get the pull request merged to the repository that for source that was closed 5 or 4 years ago.
It's true. It's a major change. So maybe we should talk a little bit about what the community is like to interact in. Like you know, one day you weren't participating in this and weren't contributing, and the next day you were. Kind of what that transition's like, and what have you found the community like to work with, and the various .NET teams like to work with?
Okay, so first of all, using C Sharp. So people have lots of ideas to improve C Sharp, and someone open issue in the repository of the design of the C Sharp language, and he asked for a feature, and I wanted to check if I can implement it, and I successfully did it and opened a pull request in the CoreCLR repository and the Roslyn compiler. The pull request for the CoreCLR already merged 2 weeks ago, and now I am working with the Roslyn team to finish and merge the pull request to the C Sharp compiler.
I see. So you'll kind of be like the owner of a C Sharp feature.
Yes, it's really exciting.
Yeah, you can definitely print a T-shirt for that, or put that on your resume. So what kind of level of satisfaction does that give you?
From the beginning, 20 years ago, when I started to program, after hitting F5 and see the program run, I asked, how do I write something that take my code and run it myself? And I wanted to do this in a real project, like a real compiler. So since then, I tried to do something like this. And when I saw that the compiler was open source, I said, this is my open opportunity to do something like that for a real compiler. And started to investigate how I can participate in this open source party.
Right, so you're clearly a smart guy. What did you kind of have to learn to make it so that you could build this change and make it good enough such that, you know, the repo maintainers would accept it?
I didn't learn in university or college a degree in computer science, but I am a self-learner. So I tried to read a lot of books in this issue of compilers, and also did a course called NAND to Tetris, that you build a computer from NAND gate and then write operating systems and compiler, and in the end you have Tetris that ran on computer that you created from scratch. And after that, I did it. I wanted to do something like that in real compiler. And as part of the F-Sharp Software Foundation mentorship program, I got a mentor that called Lincoln Atkinson. He was a F-Sharp compiler engineer in the F-Sharp team. And he showed me how to start doing it. And we started doing it with improving performance of some of the functions of the list modules. After that, we work on a big features called color member attributes that was introduced in C# 5, and we implement it for F-Sharp. And he showed me the first attribute, how we implement, and I fill the rest of the attribute, and we work on it together. And now in Visual Studio 2017, we have this feature.
That's awesome. Yeah, I know. Yes. Lincoln, super nice and smart guy. Seems like his investment in you really paid off.
Yes, after his after working with him, I continued to contribute more features to F# compiler, and then I started to look how I can contribute also to C# compiler.
Right. So I actually have that. You shared this with me earlier. I have that pull request up. Let's see if we can go here. So you won't be able to see this because I don't have screen sharing turned on with you. But, oh, I'm on the wrong one. Right, this is Visual F# pull request 1025. I think that's the one you were talking about.
Yes.
Yeah, so this looks like this was merged almost exactly 2 years ago.
Yes.
And you can see Lincoln's there kind of trying to help you. And, yeah, it looks like he gave you a ton of feedback, and you even got feedback from Don Symes, who's like, you know.
Yes, it was really exciting to get feedback from the creator of the F# language.
Yeah, I can see how that would be super great. And then it was merged by Kevin Ransom and then made part of the language.
Yes.
Well, I mean,
right.
I guess this one didn't necessarily change the language, but it's certainly into the compiler. So there's this other one you were talking about. I think now we're on CoreCLR 9189, which was just merged half a month ago. And it looks like you created it on the start of 2017. So this process was quite lengthy.
Yes, I finished it in the middle of polishing the 2.1.NET Core. And they wanted to wait until it will be finished. And this feature will be in the next version after 2.1.NET Core.
I see. So that's part of the reason why it took so long?
Yes.
Okay. Right. And it looks like here you were working with Jan. It looks like he was kind of like your mentor. And also Addy. I know both of them quite well. Yeah, so it looks like this was quite a lengthy conversation.
I have something to say. After Lincoln mentored me, I became a mentor for three guys and teach them how to contribute to the F# compiler. And in the last round, I am working with someone called William. He is working on a really great feature for the F# compiler.
Okay, so you're the teacher now.
Yes.
Very nice.
It's really, wow, really fun to do it.
Lincoln's investment is just like paying off like crazy here.
Yes.
Go ahead.
William I also told William that I want him to be a mentor in the next round of the F-Sharp program.
So I see this nice message from Jan. He's saying, after all this, thank you for your persistence in pushing this through. I find that to be quite encouraging.
Yes, it was hard to implement. The simple fix was, the first fix was simple, but there was a lot of things around to fix that the .NET Core asked, and it takes time to figure out how to do it. And I continued to work on it until I finished it, and until they approved it.
Right, so it looks like here you have a work in progress PR on the Roslyn repo of the same name, and I already have that opened up here. So it looks like this is kind of the counter, like the related change to go in the Roslyn compiler, and now you're kind of working with a different set of folks on this.
Yes.
So maybe you can kind of talk about building a feature that spans repositories and teams. Sounds like quite a challenge for someone in the community, but it seems like you're actually being successful doing that. So could you talk a little bit about that process?
Yes, because locally on my computer, I can compile both the CoreCLR and the Roslyn compiler and check that my feature works. And there are screenshots in the pull request that show that my feature works.
Right, but that's a, yeah, I saw them. They're in the CoreCLR one.
I need to wait for first preview of the next CoreCLR to be released, so I can use it in the test of the Roslyn repository.
Right. So do you know which version of C# this is going to get added to?
Yes, in the repository of Roslyn, there is a tables showing what features will be in every version, and they wrote a line in the tables that the generic attribute feature will be in the version 8 of C#.
Okay, that's what I would have expected. So it sounds like this has been pretty positive. Could you tell us a little bit about which parts you wish could have gone better, and also how you'd like to see, you know, .NET Core and or C# evolve going forward? Two very different questions.
Yes. One thing that needs to be better is the build time. Today, to compile the whole CoreCLR, it's taking a lot of time, and to check simple change is taking a lot of time to wait to the build to finish.
Okay.
What was the second question?
So was that the primary thing that you wish had been different about your experience, or anything else?
Anything more. In the Visual F# compiler, because it's smaller than the Roslyn, then the feedback is really fast. In the Roslyn compiler, it's less fast, so it's little slow.
Okay.
So more fast response.
Okay, makes sense. And so how would you like to see, now that you're one of the compiler designers and product contributors, how would you like to see .NET and C# evolve? Do you have any thoughts on that?
I don't know. I love to see what people ask, and if I ask to change in C# or in CoreCLR, and to see if something is interesting to me, I try to implement it.
Okay. Maybe a different question then. So you must have gotten some sense of working with the language designers when you got this feature. Was this generic attributes feature, was it already designed by the time you got to it?
No, someone wrote issue that he want to use something like that.
I see.
And there was a problem that involved with the CoreCLR and the Roslyn. So I started to with the Roslyn and saw the problem in the CoreCLR, and then I debugged the CoreCLR and fixed the problem.
Makes sense. I guess then, what's your take on the kind of feedback you've been receiving from the folks on the team?
As you can see in the comments, it's really exciting and people love it. And you can see also in the reactions of the GitHub, they have lots of thumbs and hearts.
Yeah, and hearts. Right. So hearts. I think what you're saying is there's a lot also of encouragement and positive attitude.
Yes, in the F-Sharp community, for example, there are some blogs that show that they use the feature.
Nice.
Yes.
Right, so that brings you more satisfaction then.
Yes.
Cool. So I kind of hear that you started from not being a community contributor. You had a really positive help and mentorship from someone who was already in the community, and in that case on the team. And then you've kind of risen up through the ranks as a way of saying it. And you now kind of have the confidence to take on more features.
Yes, I have more confidence, and I need more time. But if something is okay with my time, then I will go for it.
Nice. Okay, well, thanks so much for your time in talking today. I don't know what time it is where you're at.
8 p.m.
Okay, yeah, it's almost 12 hours difference here. And thanks for making those contributions. Your story is a great one. And clearly you're helping to make the product better.
Thank you for doing this talk. It was really exciting about it.
For sure. Okay. And thanks everyone for listening to another show of another on.NET show. And today we learned about community contribution from Avi Avni. Thanks.